So we'll get some flowers, because this spot here is where Sam died. It's very sad.
Oi, walk away, you little prick.
All right, Grandad, keep your wig on.
Thanks, Roy.
Yeah, you're good.
Hey, Sam, come here a sec.
Coach, I'm sorry.
You know what the happiest animal on Earth is? It's a goldfish. You know why?
No.
Got a 10-second memory. Be a goldfish, Sam. Yeah? Yeah, you got it. Go ahead.
We all know the value of a good leader, how they give us inspiration and how they make us feel. Now, Ted Lasso is a great example of the kind of leadership that we all appreciate. Warm, confident, patient, and optimistic. Many of us strive to find the Ted Lasso in ourselves. Those of us in leadership and those of us aspiring towards leadership understand the value of developing our skills. Being a good leader and being successful in a management role is something that needs to be continually improved. It might not always be about taking a formal approach to developing our skills, like reading a book or taking a webinar. Sometimes it's just about the desire to be better and to learn from our mistakes and our successes. But when we're trying to make sure that we are or will be a good leader or manager, we're often not 100% sure what skills we need to improve or refine. Most of the time, we're not even sure if we need to focus on our leadership skills or our management skills, or even if they're the same thing. The truth is, they're not the same thing. They're similar, and in many situations, you need to use both of them, often at the same time, but each are distinct and valuable. So let's look at each of them and how we can build both of them to find our own inner Ted Lasso. First is leadership skills. This is what most of us see and remember from our favorite bosses, coaches, or mentors. It's the personal qualities of the people that we follow, their confidence, their persistence, their patience, and their character. This is really about the people skills that we want and need from those in authority. A good leader has the qualities that makes us feel safe and want to follow them. Leadership skills are about who the person is and how they make us feel, but are not necessarily about how competent they are in what they do while they're leading us. For that, we need to talk about management skills. Now, we often only associate management skills with the workplace, but management is about the competency of organizing and executing the work, using the resources that are available to you. Now, in people management roles, that's about using the people. This works whether you're talking about a coach on a football field, a tour guide showing a group the pyramids of Egypt, a teacher developing young minds, or even a CEO of a Fortune 500 company. Management skills are about how well they can organize and manage their people to do the work. Now, getting back to the workplace, a good boss needs to be a good manager and a good leader. Most often we see bosses that are knowledgeable and competent in their work, able to organize and execute, but are not always the best at encouraging and inspiring people. And these people need leadership coaching or training. When we at Roman 3 coach or train our leadership clients, we help them become more capable and confident in their ability to empower and develop their employees. We focus on building on what they're already good at and help them become more confident in truly leading. We also fairly often see new and younger leaders who have the confidence and people skills down, but they're not sure how to get the most productive performance out of their teams. For these clients, we provide management coaching and training. We give them the tools and strategies to build on what they're already good at, how they can use their existing talents to empower and develop their employees to perform at their best. The key to remember with both leadership and management skills is to always remember when you are in a position where you are responsible for others, they are your priority. A good leader gives their employees what they need to provide their best, most productive work. A good manager provides employees the tools and resources that will make them perform at their best. So if you want to become the best boss you can be, you need to know the difference between leadership and management skills, so you can place your efforts to be as good a leader as you are a manager, and vice versa. But remember, there's always room for improvement. So if you want to improve both your leadership and management skills, a great place to get started is to click subscribe and stay up to date with us. We often publish videos with tips and strategies to help you become a stronger leader and a better manager.